This is the second lecture on three-dimensional geometry. So let's solve the question. The question is, find the equation, of set of points, say P, point is P, so that the sum of whose distances from point, which point? Point is 400 and minus 400 is equal to 10. So the solution will be very simple. Let's take P point is x, y and z, because we want to get the equation of the all those points. So if you want to find out in any other question, if you want to find out the equation, then you have to take the general point. General point will be x, y, z always. And according to the question, means let this point is A and this point is B, and it is given sum of the distance, means AP plus BP is equal to 10. Sum of the distance from both the point is 10. So by using distance formula, we can find the value of AP. How we can find? It is x minus 4 square y minus 0 square plus z minus 0 square. Okay, and similarly we can find the value of BP. How we can find? It is x plus 4 square y minus 0 square z minus 0 square. Are you getting how I am taking these distances? So when I will solve it, I will get x minus 4 whole square plus y square plus z square plus, this will be x plus 4 square and y square plus z square is equal to 10. And you know that wherever you have taken such kind of equation, you have two roots, sum in sum or difference on one side and other side a constant, and your target is you want to remove the root. Then there is a one very simple way, you will take one root on other side and one root on the other side of that root. Okay, so what you will do, just like that I am going to do this thing in this question, x minus 4 square y square plus z square. So this implies you will take this on other side, like it will become x plus 4 square y square plus z square. Yes, what happened? Z square. Now squaring both sides, it will be x, so we can square it. Okay, x square plus 16 minus 8x y square plus z square. Now a minus b whole square, a square 100 plus, when I will square it, you will get x square plus 16 plus 8x plus y square plus z square minus 2 into 10, 20, 20 root x plus 4 square plus y square plus z square. Any doubt in this step? Is it okay? Now x square cancel with x square, y square cancel with y square, z square cancel with z square. So 16 is cancelled with 16. And now what is the next step? You will take all the other things on one side and root will be on one side. Okay, so you can take this, even you can take this root on the other side, means you have a minus 20, it will become plus 20. X plus 4 square, y square plus z square, you have a 100 here. Now you will take minus 8x on the other side, you have 8 plus 8, 16x. Now this 20 you can divide it. You have x plus 4 whole square, y square plus z square, it will become 100 plus 16x upon 20. So you have 5 plus 16 by 20 means 4 over 5x. Is it okay? Correct? Now, after that, you can square both sides. Is it okay? Now, this will be cancelled. X plus 4 square, y square plus z square. Now, 5 square. 25 or 16 over 25x square plus 2ab. 2ab means 4 into 5. 5, 5 will be cancelled. 8. 8x. So, even you can solve it in more detail, like x square plus 16 plus 8x plus y square plus z square. Even you can take this x square on other side, minus 16 by 20 x square minus 8 x minus 25 is equal to 0. So you have x square minus 16 by 25 x square, it will become 25 minus 16, 9 by 25 x square. Now y square, now z square, and 8x minus 8x cancel, and you will get 16 minus 25 minus 9. Even you can take out this denominator by taking LCM, so it will become 9x square plus 25y square plus 25z square. 9 into 25, 225. Minus 225 is equal to 0. So this is the required equation of point P. P point is x, y, z. This is the answer. Understand? So next topic of three-dimensional geometry is section formula. Section formula. Okay, we have discussed this formula in even lower class also, so we know it, but I will give us one more idea, one more additional case of the section formula, and it is very, very important in many of the cases. So what is the situation of the section formula? Let us suppose you have two points, say A and B, correct? And when you will join these two points, correct? Let us suppose there is any other point, say C. Now, this point may be in the mid, but may be anywhere. Don't think I am placing this point on the mid and you are thinking it will be always in the mid. No, that will be the special case. Sometimes this point may be the middle of A, B. Middle of the line joining of A, B. So, if coordinates of A are given like x1, y1, z, and coordinates of B are x2, y2, and z2. Okay, so I want to get the coordinates of C, provided this C divide this line segment in m ratio n. Means, what is the meaning of ratio? Means AC divided by BC is equal to m ratio n. Ratio of the distances. Correct? You cannot take like AB length is m plus n. AB length is not m plus n. Sometime you have AC divided by BC means means you have a 6 and 4, you will get 3 by 2. You M will be given as 3 and N will be given as 2. But AC is not 3, AC is 6 and BC is not 2, it is 4. So you cannot take sum AB length as M plus N. This is the ratio of the distance from C point of both the points. Is it okay? If this ratio is given, then coordinates of C, let's C point is X, Y and Z. Then the coordinates of C will be M X2 plus N X1 divided by M plus N comma Y coordinate will be M into Y2 plus N into Y1 divided by M plus N and Z into
M.
Because you have done this in 2D, we have just one additional point now. It's okay. It is M Z2 plus N Z1 divided by M plus N. Now the very important thing, you will take this situation as the situation of internally. What is the meaning of internally? Means the question is, C point lies on the line joining of A and B internally. Okay, so you can ask now, sir, what is the other situation? Other situation is externally. What is the meaning of externally? C point is not lies between here, it is lies some outside, correct? But ratio will be still there. So ratios you can take, like, means you have a distance of C from A and distance of C from B, and you can have the ratio. Okay, now you need not to visualize this situation when you have the question of externally. You need not to visualize and you need not to show it where C is lying. The only question will be given, this point, find the coordinate of the point which divides the ratio of these two points internally or externally. But what will be the change when you have externally situation? You will just replace in externally, case means you replace N with minus N, just. Okay, N with minus N. So your coordinate of C will be M X2 minus N X1 divided by M minus N, M Y2 minus M Y1 divided by M plus N comma M MZ2 minus NZ1 divided by M minus N. So you need to take it only, they will not give negative sign by default. Okay, they will give, like, means this C point or some other point cutting the line joining externally in ratio like 3 ratio 4. Okay, your N is 4, M is 3. So you will take negative sign with N and you will do the same question. Correct? I hope you understand. Now we will take some examples for this situation. One more thing about this section formula. Sometime the situation is like you have to find out the midpoint. Like if A and B are the two points and C is lies between the mid of the A and B internally, okay, then this ratio will be 1 1, you know that, because when both distance are same, then when you will divide you will get 1 by 1, means M is 1 or N is 1. Then this C will become X1 plus X2 divided by 2, Y1 plus Y2 divided by 2 plus Z1 plus Z2 divided by 2. So this is mid point formula. Correct? So even with the midpoint formula, we have developed with the help of section formula by taking M or N both 1. It's okay? Now there is a question. Question number 2. P point is given. P point is given 3, 2 and minus 4. And Q point is given. Sorry, R point is given like 9, 8 and minus 10. And we want to get the ratio of when Q will, in which ratio Q will cut the line joining of PR. So Q point is also given. We have to find the ratio. So in this question, we will take ratio as K ratio 1. So whenever you want to find out the ratio, you will take ratio K ratio 1. So see the how I am solving it. Sometimes you will find the value of K and you are not checking whether it is correct or not. You have to check also. How you will check? Now see it. Now first you know that by section formula, so value, the coordinate Q will be K into 9K plus 1 into 3 divided by K plus 1. This is the x coordinate of Q and it is given 5. Yes or no? Now by cross multiply, you can find 9K plus 3 is equal to 5 into K plus 1. It will be 9K plus 3, 5K plus 5, 9K minus 5K is equal to 5 minus 3. This will become 4K is equal to 2 and K is equal to 1 divided by 2. And you are getting positive, means this is the case of internal. And you have to verify whether you, whatever the value of K you got, whether it is correct or not. So how you will check? You will take the second coordinate. Second coordinate will be K into 8, means 8K plus 1 into 2 divided by K plus 1. This is the Y coordinate. And you know that the Y coordinate is 4. You will put the value of K that you have in this Y coordinate. If you are getting 4, that means your K is correct. So I am going to substitute the value of K. K is 1 by 2 plus 2 divided by 1 by 2 plus 1. So this will be 4. You have 4 plus 2, 6 divided by, here LCM, you will take LCM, you have 3 by 2. Now you will get 2 into 6 by 3. So you are getting 2, you are 2 into 2, 4. Means it is verified, here is 4 and here is 4. Means this way you will solve this kind of question. Yellow.
Sir, question regarding body temperature. Sir, put your hand.